Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Kedar, and on this channel we talk about design, architecture, parametric design and generative AI. And today's video is going to be a quick guide on how to select the best GGUF model for your computers. That could be for WAN 2.2, Flux or any other future model which will have a quantized version of it. And to do this, we'll be going through the Hugging Face website. And now here you will see I am going through a WAN 2.2 model, a Text2 V1, and I'm here in Files and Versions tab. So besides that, you will see something called as a model card. If you click on this, you will see all the quantized versions from Q2 to Q8. I will link my WAN 2.2 video, which talks about how quantization actually works. And above that, you will see something called as Add Hardware for Estimation. If you click on this, you'll be greeted with this particular page where you can add your hardware. So you can add a GPU, CPU or Apple Silicon if you're using. But before you add your computer configuration, I would recommend you to log in, and you can log in through your Gmail or create a new separate ID altogether. What this will do, this will be useful the next time you want to download another model. Your computer configuration already exists and you can simply select rather than adding the computer details again. So I would recommend you log in before adding your computer details, and then you can select if you want to add a GPU, CPU or Apple Silicon. I'm going to say I want to add a GPU. Then it will ask you select a provider, whether it would be Nvidia, AMD, Intel or Qualcomm. I'm going to select Nvidia, and then it will ask you select the GPU model. So if you click on this, you will get all of the GPUs that are available, and I'm going to select the RTX 4090 mobile, which basically means the laptop version of RTX 4090. And if I click on this, you will see the VRAM, which in my case is 16 GB, and number of items, which will be 1 because it's the only computer that I'm using. And then you can simply say add item. And if you click on add item, your GPU will be seen here. So it says GPU Nvidia RTX 4090 mobile 16 GB. And below that you will see this gradient from red to green with some random number coming here which says 32.98 TFLOPS, which basically stands for tera floating point operations per second. And once your model is added here, you can go back to your GGUF model page, and here you will see there is a green and orange tick and a red cross. Now what does this mean? So green stands for this model is likely to run on your hardware, orange means this model can probably run on your hardware, and red means this model is probably too large for your hardware. So in my case, which is a 4090 16 GB VRAM mobile card, I can't use the Q8. I can use a Q6, but I'm not using. What I'm using is a Q5KM, which is what I've been using in my previous two videos as well. So this is a simple way of understanding what model is useful for your computers. And you can also add multiple GPUs. So you see this icon here, which is like a settings icon. If I click on this, I will come back to this page and I can add another hardware. Now in this case, I am adding a Nvidia RTX 3050, again a laptop version, which is around 6 GB of VRAM. And now you will see this TFLOPS has increased from 32 to 40 because it's a combination of both. So I've added a 4090 and a 3050. And now if I go back again to the GGUF model, now if I click here near the Nvidia logo, I can now select whether I want to check this model configuration for 4090 or for 3050. So if I click on 3050, you will see most of these models will not run on a 3050 6 GB VRAM, but the Q2K will run. So this is a way how you can add multiple GPU, CPU or even Apple Silicon processor and select the model that will work for your own systems. Okay, again to remind you, green means it will work, orange means it will probably work, red means it will definitely not work. So select the model according to the color combination. And like I said in the beginning of the video, this is not only for WAN, even for FluxNell. Now because I have logged in, you will see automatically it will tell me which models are usable, which are not. So in this case, the 23 GB is out of the question. Ideally, it says use Q6K. I am using Q80, which works on my computer. So like I said, the green or the orange is really fine. Don't go with the red one. And similarly with the Flux Dev also, a similar kind of color configuration I get. So I can use anything up to Q8. I can't really use the F16 model. Okay. So that's how for your individual GPU and CPU or Apple Silicon, you can test which model will work for your computers and then download it. So that's all I wanted to show for this video. It's going to be one of the shortest video that I have done, but I think it was important to just give you a quick guide on how to do this. But anyway, that's it. Thank you for your time. Please do like, share and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.